We'll just use the one that we have created here. Okay. Okay, so it says login has been successful and we have started to the scan for it. I'm clicking here to start the scanning of the products. Here I have a Yardley soap. I'm gonna use this barcode to scan with this barcode scanner. So I'll just simply scan it. So now it shows you on the screen the barcode number, name, and the cost of the item and the total so far of the items that we have in the card. Next product I have here to scan is the tissues that we have. You know, it also has the barcode here. I'm gonna scan it with the scanner. So now I'm gonna scan this in the product and it has been added to the list again. So here, as you see, the total has been shifted to the next level and it shows all the items in the cart that we have or the items that we have scanned. Now if I go to pay my total, it asks me for the payment options. We have two payment options here. One is of the credit card and one is of the debit card. So for demo purpose, I'm using my this card which has magnetic stripe, and I'll just simply use the debit card option. This card that has been used is just for the demo purpose. So the database has the details of this card, which you know, can track if the card is valid or not. As these card details are there in the database, it will approve the payment. If I use some other card, it is gonna not accept the payment. So let's see. Now I'm swiping this card in the magnetic stripe reader and the screen says payment completed successfully, thank you for shopping with us, and there it ends. Now I have just one more module to introduce you, which is for the admin access, where the admin can check for the stock availability. Here it says that we have Yardley soap, Kleenex tissues, breadboard. Here the admin can update the stocks according to the newly added stocks, or if they have a new product incoming or new product introduced in the market, they can use this update stock option. So I'll go with it. I'll show you. So if I see enter the name of the product, if I say Yardley, and if I enter the number of items to be added, so for in this case, if I add 20 items more to the stock, it will again ask me to verify, it will ask me to scan the product barcode just to verify that the product is correct, because as we know, the same product name might have different barcodes according to the size of the product. So here this details have been updated successfully. Now if we see the stocks again, it will show us that this Yardley soap has been added with 20 more products. Earlier it was 95, if you have noticed. Now it is 115. Okay, that's all. Okay, thank you so much. Please let me know in the comment section if you guys have any queries, any suggestions, or how did you like the project I have done so far. I would really appreciate your any kind of guidance or comments with the critics. Thank you so much.